Usually I don't revisit songs if I've already covered them before, especially several months after the fact, but... Well, I feel like I really needed time to sit with this one, to process how I feel about it, and given how brief my coverage of it was the first time around, yeah, I'd really like to take another crack at this one. So, let's do it. As far as the sound goes, my thoughts haven't really changed. It's a really solid ballad, played on a piano that doesn't sound absolutely pristine, but that just gives it texture. And while the piano work itself is fairly basic, mostly just playing chords or doubling the vocal melodies, it's doing what it needs to and giving Joji plenty of space to take center stage.
She'd take the world off my shoulders. If it was ever hard to move.
And as a vocalist, Joji fits the song well. He's not a powerhouse performer, but goddamn if he can't emote. And he's smart enough to layer some harmonies to give the chorus a bit more oomph than the verses, too. But it's mostly his heart-wrenching delivery that sells the emotion of the song.
Tell me, save us your glory. Does he laugh the way I did?
And that's really what I want to focus on in this re-review, since the content is where my thoughts have changed the most, where giving the song time to unfold has really helped solidify my feelings on it. Though, I do want to recap my initial interpretation first, where Joji is in a relationship with the perfect girl who genuinely loves him and cares about him, yet he can't return those feelings towards her, because he's still not over his last partner. It sucks for them both, and they're doomed from the start because of Joji's inability to move on.
When you're outside.
And I probably should have placed a bit more emphasis on this, but yes, this is clearly Joji's fault, even if he's suffering as well. But it works because he paints himself as sympathetic. He's aware that it's his fault, and he's not sour at either his new girl or his old one. This isn't a want you back type of situation or anything. Or is it?
Maybe you'll start slipping slow, find me again.
See, the part of the song I didn't really talk about, and the part that kinda made the whole thing fall apart for me, is the second verse where Joji starts daydreaming about what his ex and her new partner are doing together, and projecting his own insecurities onto her in the process. Which, I'm sorry, but that's more than a little skeevy. Harmless, but skeevy. But it's the kind of thing that sabotages that ability to build sympathy, and makes me have to reassess the rest of the song in a new light, which, well, when I do that, the whole thing really unravels.
Said I'm fine, said I'm good.
You get the sense that Joji isn't dating this girl for any of her own qualities, he's tried to fall in love with her and failed, and he's even recognized that it's never gonna work, but he's still leading her on solely because she reminds him of his ex, and he's too lost in his own heartbreak to let go of her.
Perfect don't mean that it's working, so what can I do?
It's a selfish reason, and one that comes at the expense of this girl's feelings. The responsible thing would be to own up to it, to tell her how he truly feels, and give himself time to properly move on before trying again with someone else. But the way the song's written suggests stagnation, a refusal to take those steps. Things are going to continue to suck for the both of them, and that's entirely on Joji's shoulders. So no, I don't think I'm really okay with this anymore. Like, I could nitpick about other small issues. The bridge we do get is lovely, but if we had gotten a proper bridge to really flesh out the narrative, maybe that could have been the missing piece to tie it all together or suggest some degree of progress. And the song itself doesn't really build to anything. It's as stagnant as its narrative. The first chorus and the last chorus sound virtually identical, but like, the main issue for me really is just the emotional core missing its mark.
Bro, what are you doing?
Do I think it's a bad song? Well, no, it's fine. Not gonna be anywhere close to my worst list, cause like, at its core, the song is too well composed to be anything less than decent, and the lyrics, while flawed, aren't offensive or gross or anything, just off-putting. But with its emotional resonance sabotage, the song really doesn't have much else to offer beyond its sound. And I feel like if the song sounded exactly the same except someone else was singing it, it wouldn't be nearly as acclaimed, which, well, that's a thought now, isn't it? Like, Joji. We all like Joji, right? I mean, hell, I already put him on a best list, and I've generally liked everything else I've heard from the man, too. He's someone we're all just inclined to like, because he's a guy who's in the middle of transitioning from internet famous to famous famous, and like, that's a great story. A rise to glory from the most obscure corners of YouTube all the way to the top of the charts. And I mean, if you can inflict a Harlem Shake upon the world and come out the other side more beloved than ever, well, at that point, you're basically unimpeachable. You can do no wrong. No wrong. Ever.
I know you're not.
like, maybe what bothers me is how Joji almost feels more like a cult of personality than, like, an actual person sometimes. It's almost uncanny how many Song of the Year or One of the Best Songs Ever comments I've seen heaped upon Glimpse of Us. Everyone just seems to love it. I'm sure saying that just sent some contrarian out to the comments, but, like, generalizing here. But what if this was a Giveon song? For tonight, I'm yours. He has a pretty similar voice after all. Or maybe a Sam Smith song? Hell, even a Lewis Capaldi song? Oh god, if it was a Lewis Capaldi song, that'd be okay, maybe not that last one, but you get the idea, right? Artists where, you know, there are plenty of people who like them, and a lot of people who don't, too. Artists who are not as naturally sympathetic as Joji. I think the flaws, the cracks in the narrative would be a lot more apparent if the song was handed off to one of them. But with Joji? Cause sometimes I look in your eyes. When you already hold such a strong positive bias towards an artist, when there's so much hype and universal acclaim around them, I think you're naturally inclined to be more sympathetic towards them. Hell, I certainly was when I first covered the song. And that's exactly what Glimpse of Us needs to land, that sympathy. It doesn't have to be earned, it isn't questioned, because nobody wants to question it. And I feel that inherent bias is what leads to a lack of, well, actually wanting to engage with the song. People simply want to enjoy it, and I'm not here to try and take that away from anyone either. It's cool to enjoy things, I just think it's also worth it to not blindly consume anything and everything from your favorite artists just because they were the ones who made it. Like, this is kind of a problem with stan culture too. I hear you groaning, I'm not gonna go too deep into this, don't worry, but just to bring up a few examples. This one is for the boys with the booming system, top town AC with the coolest system. There are Nicki Minaj songs I really like, and Nicki songs I don't like. Taylor songs I like, Taylor songs I don't like. BTS songs I like, BTS songs I don't like. Though, to be fair, even the fans don't like this one, but you get the point. Even artists I really enjoy tend to have at least a few stinkers under their belts. Obviously, I'm not gonna deny having at least some biases towards or against artists, and I am not shy at all about being biased against certain artists as people. But going into every song with an open mind, regardless of who made it, and trying to judge it on its own merits, I think that's what helps me really connect with, really enjoy the music that I love the most. And I think a refusal to do that, or at least an unconscious unwillingness to, is detrimental towards your relationship with art in the long term. You can only blindly consume for so long before you get sick of that one flavor and move on to the next one, you know? And it works the other way too. If an artist never has to change or improve to stay relevant, they're not really incentivized to try at all. That's how we ended up with Drake. Again, my goal here isn't to go, hey, stop enjoying this thing that I don't enjoy, but rather to ask you, the viewer, to reflect upon how you engage with art, because, and I promise you this, because I know it from experience, the more you put into it, the more you'll get out of it in return. Maybe it'll lead to some stars not shining quite as brightly as you'd like, but it may well lead to others shining brighter than you ever thought possible. And it's worth it to catch that glimpse of something special. I'm Crow, and I hope y'all have a good night.